What is up, people? It is your boys, new Jesus, back with another video. We are here. I'm your host, or one of your hosts, Marcus D. Butler.
And I am the Arsenal, Dwayne Butler, of course.
And we are here via Discord because J. Cole chose to release a song at 9:30 at night
on a Wednesday.
When did we do that? Not, but
off season is coming.
Yes, Portantonio.
Fall off's coming.
Oh yeah, no, I just thought about that. Off season already came. Portantonio with a 5 minutes and 16 seconds. Is he going to talk about? What is he going to talk about? I feel like he's going to talk about like that apology stuff. Maybe, maybe not. Who knows? Hopefully
they
he
might,
does.
They might mention it, maybe.
So they can shut up. But yeah, y'all, link in the description to the original video, I guess. But let's get into this. All right, if you haven't seen the other reactions from us, go check them out. All right, let's get it. Yeah.
It's a long intro,
Cole. No, it's like, get to it. Get to it now.
Young Jermaine walked the straight and narrow. Minimum wage jobs for the narrow. But still my mind was on the zeros. I fiend for the perks that was seen flipping birds. So we were skipping church, but my eyes was on the sparrows. Niggas in the past. Okay. I'm a sparrow. It's the old gospel thing.
Yeah.
His eye on the sparrow, and I know he watches me.
We're going to take it back about, what is that, 5 seconds.
On the sparrows, niggas flipping pies, spending thousands on apparel. Shit, I want to shine too. I want dimes too. Jealous niggas want to know just how my rhymes blew. Mono we mono, I'm bono, I'm you times two. Now I'm bougie, I done outgrew the fountain blue. But never forgot the spot where I developed my plot. To dwell at the top, the veer where all my skeletons lock. If I could do it all over, then I never would swap. I seen good, I seen bad, had my melanin mocked. I seen lifelong friends turn to devilish ops. I was Mike in red leather trying to tell him to stop. You better beat it before you see that heavy metal get popped. Wait, pause it. He said, wasn't red leather the song he did in the future?
Yeah.
He said, I was Mike with red leather trying to tell him to stop.
Oh.
He said something like that. He said people, something. He said, my friends, something like that. I was clapping red leather trying to tell him to stop. Something like that. I misinterpreted, but it's like he said that. He's like,
back it up. Let me back it up. Pause. No. All right, let's go back.
I was Mike in red leather trying to tell him to stop. You better beat it for you see that.
Sorry, hold on. I was Mike in red leather trying to tell him to stop. You better beat it. I was Mike in red leather trying to tell him to stop. I think he said.
Yeah. Think it kind of sounds like he's listening to that, maybe.
Red leather trying to tell him to stop. Let me go back a little bit more.
Okay. Call, like, tell his friends, like Kendrick and Drake, to stop or something. I don't know.
It could be. Yes, he is. He said, I see lifelong friends. I was like, I paused at the right moment. Okay.
Yeah, lifelong friends turned devilish ops. You better beat it before you see that heavy metal get pop. He was a mean ass wing with a hell of a shot. But if no team draft king, he gonna bet on the block. He wanna ball till he falls until the federals knock and sit his ass on the bench for moving careless with rock. You can't relate unless your father was not around and your mother went out and found someone else and then brought around and they salaries didn't combine when they married and brought you out of that poverty. Then you moved to a soft little part of town so that when you back in the hood, you feel awkward about it now.
God damn it. Not off of this 100 pounds, it was off. No, God dang. Listen off everything.
He can keep that rhyme scheme going for like a long time. It's not repetitive. Like, he can keep that going throughout the song. He'll go back to it like throughout the song. Like, what the hell?
Flow on flow, no words is the same. No verse is the same. Wait, actually, that's a bar. Flow on flow, no verse is the same. Sorry, my bad. Today is about Cole. Let me not rap. Today is about Cole. They're not here for my bars. Alright, let's go. Let's get back. Let me go back a little bit. Get back into it. Little part of town, so that when you back in the hood, you feel awkward about it now. Then your confidence start to drown, but the rapper gave you some positive thoughts, so you jot them down. You jot them down. Ride to it. Ride to it. Is that what you said? Yeah.
Ride to it.
Are you singing?
It's the
whole song. So he is kind of is addressing the thing, but he ain't at the same time. He's addressing the whole of rap. Oh my god. This one's better than hello, I'll tell you that much. I'll tell you that right now. I realize that we haven't. Okay, if y'all want to see a ranking of our albums, of the albums of J. Cole, let us know and we'll put it out. We haven't filmed it yet, nothing like that. All right, let's see. Let me go back a little bit, actually. He was hitting them notes. Y'all niggas ain't stopping me.
Y'all niggas ain't stopping me. Y'all niggas ain't stopping me.
I thought the beat finished soon. Flows reverse time to find deliveries good as mine. You gotta search primes. I'm scaling heights high and birds can perch trying to be something. Hoping that peace comes to my cursed mind. One thing's for sure that I've matured from my first rhyme. I learned long ago you can't please them all and it hurts trying. In this game, what all you got is your name like. You know,
please them all and it hurts trying. You go around life trying to make everybody happy, you end up making yourself unhappy.
Yeah, I know it by heart. The thing about Cole that irritates me is that nigga got too many good bars that she's like, you thinking back at that last bar while he's still rapping, you're like, oh, I just got that bar. And then he just keeps going like, what did I just miss? God damn it. And it's gonna keep going into the next bar, because that blue line or that blue lyric was going into multiple bars. God dang. All right, go back. First mind. One thing's for sure that I've matured from my first rhyme. I learned long ago you can't please them all and it hurts trying. In this game where all you've got is your name like dirt, I'm smirking at niggas trying to be smirched mine. Of certain times, with a fake get told it is wise. I can see hating both of your eyes, but the third's blind. So you search lines, but you struggle, which explains the
point. That's a good one too.
The word finds.
I
hate what raps become, but like do not disturb signs. Cannot get if I see it's about the dough. They instigate the fuckery because it's profitable. But singing stop the violence tools with dudes in hospitals. I pulled the plug because I seen where that was about to go. They wanted blood, they wanted clicks to make their pockets grow. They see this fire in my pen and think I'm
about to smoke. He's talking about the beef. He said, I pulled the plug because I seen where that was going to go. Said they wanted blood, they wanted this. They want to see their pockets grow. They want to capitalize off of me being hate. No, putting hate out there, especially by the guy that I'm friends with.
He apologized for a reason. I mean, maybe y'all can get off his.
He said their eyes. And he said the third eye is blind. Third eye is usually by your mind. So you see your mind is still closed off. Jacoby's spitting that stuff.
maybe now y'all can get off his ass. I can sing too, goddamn. No, let's go back a little bit.
Y'all niggas ain't stopped. They see this fire in my pen and think I'm dodging smoke. I wouldn't have lost the battle,
dog. I would have lost the pro. I would have gained the hold on.
Now, I'm a huge Lamar fan, you guys know, but you lost that battle. But it would have been a good battle to go against. It'd be like Goku and Vegeta, you know, who always win? Goku. But It'd be good to
now,
see.
Now, you know? if this wasn't a video, I'll just be kicking him off of the Discord. But no. Not at that bar. I would have lost a bro. Yeah. He didn't say bros. He did not say bros. He did say bro.
Yeah, but I don't think I think Kendrick Lamar and J. Cole, they did battle. It would have been like personal. It would have been just like, I'm better than him.
Yeah,
I'm better than him.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. Like that. Say,
what's your lyrics? Yeah, LeBron and Kevin Durant going at it in the finals. They don't hate each other. They're cool. But it's just like, we just compete to see who the best.
Yeah.
Now, that other one is different. That's different. Yeah. That's different level.
Nigga ain't want no triple threat. Well, excuse me. It won't be no damn triple threat. It'll be a Royal Rumble against two other niggas because Drake going to have a lot of riders on his side. But nah, we ain't going to talk about that. All right, let's take it back a little bit. Can I get it by seeing about the dough? They instigate the fuckery because it's profitable. But singing stop the violence tools with dudes in hospitals. I pulled the plug because I seen where that was about to go. They wanted blood, they wanted clicks to make their pockets grow. They see this fire in my pen and think I'm dodging smoke. I wouldn't have lost the battle, dog. I would have lost the pro. I would have gained a phone and all for what? Just to attain some old props from strangers that don't got a clue what I've been aiming for since the age of 14. Jermaine is no king if that means I got to dig up dirt and pay the whole team of algorithm bot niggas just to sway the whole team. Talking about Drake. What the fuck did he just say?
Go back. He's talking about, that sound like a little tourist. What's the name? He said, dig up old dirt. And to try to find some people, and he said also to pay bots, who known for paying bots to mean people. And that got Mr. Aubrey written all over it.
So, that's what I was like, come on, pay bots
and make memes and this like that. He was doing all that stuff on the internet, making the memes about kids in their posts, ain't no memes. So this is the only director towards stuff like that. He's like, I ain't trying to do all that stuff. And it sounded like he was saying, I want to do it, but it's kind of like a diss, him saying it. Like, I don't know.
Childish Gambino said it best. You spend more time on the captions than the music. Or I forget what exact the bar was, but you spend more time on your caption than your music. I'm like, what the heck is going on? That man.
Yeah, run that one back.
Yes.
Run that back.
What the heck? I said, okay. I knew he was gonna talk about this damn bit. I don't know how, but I knew for 5 minutes he gonna talk about something. He's talking about something.
Yeah, I get this off my chest.
So I'm tired of this.
Get it off your chest like breast reductions. So he said that Beyonce song. You gotta get off your chest sometimes.
I'm taking it back. Taking it back to 3 minutes and 39 seconds and play. Since the age of 14, Jermaine is no king. If that means I gotta dig up dirt and pay the whole team of algorithm bot niggas just to sway the whole thing on social media, competing for your favorable memes to be considered best to live and rest, the weight of both things. I understand the thirst of being first that made them both swing, protecting legacies. So lines got crossed, perhaps regrettably. My friends went to war, I walked away with all they blood on me. Now some of these credit me, try wipe away my pedigree, but please find a nigga out that's rapping this incredibly. My dog texted me, I share the words he said to me. If you refuse to shoot the gun, don't mean the gun ain't deadly.
Refuse to shoot the gun, don't mean the gun is not deadly. And that is true. That is true. Hey, if I had hit 47, but he's hey, you know it's dangerous without even shooting it. He said that's a good part. He said like his two friends. It's like J. Cole in the anime or something. Like, two friends battling. And he like Sakura when Naruto and Sasuke was fighting. And he's looking on like, stop!
Let's not say Sakura. More like a Kakashi. Well, like,
the terms of that, yeah. It's like, you got to see the blood of my two friends on me. I'm like, dang. Man, that's a good bar right there.
J. Cole.
What's it working for? Is it like just to have some memes for the social media, make memes about it and do certain things and laugh at you guys going at each other like that and stuff? But hey, sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do.
Yeah. God, let's take it back to 4-5 and play.
That's rapping this incredibly. My dog texted me, I share the words he said to me. If you refuse to shoot the gun, don't mean the gun ain't deadly. I guess in that metaphor, hypothetically, the gun is me. I text her back like, guess a gun ain't what I'm trying to be, my nigga.
They stripped me of my spot and now I'm finally free, my nigga. They say I'm picking sides, they don't you lie on me, my nigga. To start another war, hey, Drake, you'll always be my nigga. I ain't ashamed to say you did a lot for me, my nigga. Fuck all the narrative.
Okay.
Tapping back into your magic pen is what's imperative. Reminding these folks why we do it. It's not for beefing, it's for speaking our thoughts, pushing ourselves, reaching the charts, reaching your minds, deep in your hearts, creeping to find emotions to touch, something inside to open you up, help you cope with the rough times and shit. I'm sending love because we ain't prime and shit. My nigga, y'all niggas ain't stopping me. Yeah.
Okay, okay, Cole.
Okay.
He said, don't you lie on me. he said, I'm friends with him, and I'm friends with him. Like that, I'm cool with them. When the Kendrick did good cool things together, and then Drake did cool things together, he said, I'm not picking sides and choosing, like, this or that side and stuff like that, in a sense. Now, everybody has a different mindset. Now,
yeah, I was going to say, yeah,
it's the cold going to tie in, I understand his standpoint like that, in a sense, but if somebody was talking about my family, I'm going to have to pop out of soul.
I guess that's the thing. I guess that's the thing for Cole. He didn't have nothing like being said about him and his family for Drake and Kendrick. Drake was saying stuff about his family, so he's like, you do what you do. But
my wife and putting pictures of her up and posting up her old college house and saying, "All right, it's doing too much. It's going too far now."
So that's not like. I mean, people get mad at Cole, but imagine if Kendrick didn't say nothing back. Okay, well, he did it also, but yeah.
Yeah, no, Kendrick crazy, he's Gemini. him, Tupac, Prince, they're going to fire back.
I want to hear what he says about Drake again. I know he says he cool with him and everything, but let me see what he has.
They're lying for me.
Oh wait, that's not the part that I'm looking at.
Touch something inside to open you up, help you cope with the rough times and shit.
So what? Yeah, I'm saying it is, baby.
Start another war, hey Drake, you'll always be my nigga. I ain't ashamed to say you did a lot for me, my nigga. Fuck all the narratives, tapping back into your magic.
I guess he's mainly saying he don't know nothing about that other stuff, but he's saying that the stuff that you done for me.
Drake Cole switching up on Drake. When we can say he's on the future and stuff. And ASAP Rocky, like, no, I'm just rapping. I have nothing to do with that.
Yeah, I ain't got nothing to do with that. What did he say? No, ain't got nothing to do with them.
He said like a relief too. He said them battling on the first place. They took my spot away. He said like a relief. So like not challenging for first in a sense. And you see, it's kind of like people's comparing it purposely. It's like the Mars, the Malcolm X, Drake, and Drake Cole is the Martin Luther King.
Yeah.
You know, peaceful approach. I was trying to see like just the rap, but I don't condone violence. But sometimes, you know, like Malcolm X said, you gotta get your hands dirty sometimes. Sometimes you run out there and start fighting back.
I mean, I can see exactly where Cole was coming from, because it was when he was initially about to have like the beef with Kendrick. He was gonna be like, okay, yeah, it's gonna be fun. We're gonna be doing this. He's gonna have some good songs come out, and he was seeing what's gonna happen. He said, oh hell no. Let me get the heck out of here, and let me get.
Before Schoolboy Q was the one told J. Cole about like where it's gonna go. Like he said, like, no, he's not doing this for you. He's not doing this for you. He's done this tour. It's something else. It's something else.
Like, yeah, let me go ahead.
Like, oh, okay. You know, tomorrow he's like Magneto. J. Cole, Professor X. I tell you, like Professor X, Magneto. Like, no, we can't do this. No, we gotta get rid of the culture vultures. The mutants gotta go.
Said Charles. Charles, I love you. I love you as a friend, but you better get the frick out of my way. I'm finna beat they ass.
The vultures are the humans.
Yeah.
The mutants are the people who are part of the culture.
Yeah. All right, let's continue.
Pen is what's imperative, reminding these folks why we do it. It's not for beefing, it's for speaking our thoughts, pushing ourselves, reaching the charts, reaching your minds, deep in your hearts, creeping to find emotions to touch, something inside to open you up, help you cope with the rough times and shit. I'm sending love because we ain't prime and shit. My nigga,
nigga saying stop with me. Y'all niggas saying, I'm gonna start crying. y'all niggas.
It's a cold story. All people like discredit him like being the best. I'm like, just because he didn't do this battle, that means he's not the best. I'm like, he's doing the best. the best. He's still, I still have him top two. I have him top two. It never changed. My list never changed.
What's your number three?
Number three. I guess by default, I'd be Drake up there at number three. by default.
Shit, I ain't got
number one. Number one is definitely Kendrick for me. He's my favorite. That's why I'm biased. But if somebody said J. Cole's number one, I'm cool with that too because J. Cole's very good. So it's really bad. Like, it really matters.
Yeah,
very good.
If you're talking about like in generational like stuff, like all time type thing, that's a different story. But my own personal, it's number one is J. Cole, number two is Kendrick, definitely. And it can flip flop no matter the. Actually, no, it's been J. Cole since the beginning. But number three has flip flopped a lot. JID probably would be up there, but we'll see.
Oh yeah, JID is very good. He said something coming out too. Something coming out as well. And Isaiah Rashad.
Hopefully, yes. Hopefully, got Cole in that tune. Hopefully, got Cole in that one. That'd be good. Yeah. Y'all, that was what we needed from Cole.
That's good.
That's exactly what we needed from Cole. Because y'all been blowing this man up too much. It's annoying. But, no.
Nah. I'm about to call Fall Off. There ain't no Fall Off in me.
Yeah. Still putting out amazing features. Let us know, y'all. What do y'all think of this song? The Port Antonio. Antonio, is that a place or something like that? Let me see. Since I'm on PC.
They're
going
crazy on that song.
Oh, Jamaica.
Maybe they wrote that there, maybe.
It's a city in Jamaica.
Maybe wrote it there.
The nigga would make it word there. So people been finding J. Cole like in different places. Sorry, finding him in different places just writing. He'd be like, that man locked in. Like that's what the fall off.
That man said my two friends battled it out as I walked away and they blood on me. I'm like,
yeah. Well, y'all let us know what y'all think of the song. What you think of everything that's going on. Whose side are you? Nah, it's funny, I ain't gonna say what side you on. There ain't no sides. We already know who won, and it's over.
They just said, "Same biggest."
But yeah, let us know what y'all think of this song, and we'll see y'all on the next video. Again, like it up, give us to some likes to do a album ranking. Yeah. I'm about to do my outro. Whoops. I'll see y'all. We'll see y'all later. Peace.
It's out.
And happiness.